it was, we didn't know where we was going when we got our orders until we got on board ship, and then we found out we were going to North Africa. We run around in the ocean out there a bunch, because it didn't take that long to sail straight to North Africa, but they was trying to deceive the enemy as to where we was going and all that stuff. There was no beach where we landed. I mean, no, we could just drive out on it. And so the troop ship anchored about a mile and a half offshore, and we boarded landing craft. Our first landing, we didn't meet any resistance. The enemy didn't have anyone resisting us on the beach when we went in. I climbed over. When we climbed over, we were supposed to go in four landing craft to the wave going into the beach. Well, we got our boat, our landing craft loaded, and nobody was busy getting the other three landing craft loaded, and I didn't do. And so we were just circling, waiting for them to get ready to load, and I couldn't see anything happening. And the other wave was going on in. We could see it getting out there, plumb out, way out in front of us. And I finally told the coxswain, I said, let's get out of here, because we don't want to be sitting here and going in by ourselves in case we get aircraft to strafe us. And so we took off behind that other wave, just one boat, one landing craft. And so we went in half a mile behind the wave in front of us, because the other, I don't know what happened to the other. We're headed across country to this air base. Of course, we weren't the only ones doing it, so we had people coming from the right and people coming from the left, and we were going up the middle, and we were into the, by dark that night, or getting dark. Well, we were getting pretty close to the air base, and we hadn't run across, and nobody had bothered us. But it was just before dark. Well, the people that was in charge, wherever they were, discovered us, and they started shelling us with artillery. And we had stopped to get our bearings and see what we was doing. And about that time, well, we got into our first artillery barrage. And of course, that was brand new. We'd never been shot at before. I found out what shrapnel looked like when it's fire, when the shell explodes. It was dark enough that I could see the shrapnel. It was white hot. Here's the airfield that was our objective. And the Germans the French were subject to the Germans. The Germans had taken over France, and there was French troops in North Africa, and the Germans pulled out and left a lot of French troops there. Of course, they didn't want to fight anyway, in fact, they joined us, and our outfit trained them, and they went on to fight with the Allies. But after we got through with the air field and had it secure and was usable, and after a few weeks, well, we started up towards Algeria, and we couldn't go the straight route because Spanish Morocco was in there, and they were neutral. We had to go around, and we went up by the side of the Sahara Desert. Our objective up there was the British were pushing Rommel out of North Africa then, or out on the desert. And our objective was going out of north of Oran and up there in Algeria, and make a sort of a blockade where Rommel couldn't turn around. They were heading him towards Tunis, and that's where they left Africa. The German troops did, those that didn't get killed, of course. They went. Rommel got his troops out of North Africa into Sicily and on into to Europe. Made a landing at Palermo, Sicily, and we weren't the only ones doing that, of course, our outfit was. There was a lot of people. The British were landing there and a lot of other divisions, American divisions, were landing. And we had objectives and the British had objectives. And one of our objectives was to go all the way across the island and link up with the people on the other side, the troops on the other side. But the country is very mountainous, and we couldn't go across there with vehicles, so they sent us some pack mules in.